Hey guys, my name is Justin Williams from the Legion of Los Angeles. And today we're here with professional skateboarder Eric Koston. We're gonna head over to UNDEFEATED and look at some kicks.
I started collecting sneakers when I was 19. My first trip to Japan, and I saw these tiny little sneaker shops with, like, you know, saran wrap, dead stock Jordan 1s.
Yeah.
This is, like, early on. This is, you know, 1994.
What do you, like, usually look for, like, when you walk into a store? Like, what's the first thing that catches your eye? It's colors and materials. Yeah.
One, like, just premium leather. Like, these ones. Like, look, like on these. I do look at those things, you know, like that snakeskin Air Force One.
Yeah.
Stuff like that, like.
How important is the, like, the shoe and how it reacts to, like, what you're doing? Because, like, I think cycling now, I can tell, like, what anything is doing, like, any little detail I can feel, is it kind of the same?
I'm sure it is with cycling. It's the same with skateboarding. It's like, it's just your feet are kind of like your hands, you know, down there. If something's not reacting right, the way a certain thing flicks when you flip the board, you feel like you're detached from the skateboard. So,
I'm excited. You got a big smile on your face.
No, this one, I just thought this one might be kind of funny. This is a signature golf sneaker from the Koston 2.
No way.
This is a golf sneaker at retail. Next is, like, is also what I'm wearing. One of a color up on a Jordan 1. You know, friends of mine had them, and they were $24.99. I'm like, I'm getting a chance to make a Jordan 1 low color up. I wanted to make the shoe that I never got.
Oh, so you didn't end up getting it?
No, I didn't get it.
Oh.
I was just like, had to walk away. Like,
dude.
We put the $24.99 on it. It's still a trip to see my name, even though I hid it on a label inside the tongue. Another life hammer is a collab with Koston.
The Mambas.
So this is my first shoe. This is the sole tooling for my first shoe and the real Kobe 6 upper. And we only sold 24 pairs of these.
Just 24?
All the money went to,
period.
To charity.
Like, just 24 period?
24 pairs, yeah. My name and his name on a shoe, I just, like, I still trip out on it, you know? And it's even more sad that he's gone, but it's, like, I'm so grateful that that ever happened.
This is your favorite shoe?
I mean, yes, that I've done.
Yeah.
Yes, that's my favorite shoe that I've done is that shoe. So you're 10 and a half, right?
Yeah.
I grabbed a 10 hoping that's an average size, but I do have a 10 and a half. I'm gonna give you a pair.
Oh, wow.
I do have it at home, yes. I just checked. I was like, I have a 10 and a half, but, and I
Dude,
just grabbed a 10.
Crazy.
I wanted to give you a
thank
pair.
You.
Yeah.
So much. Like, cycling just, it's not this, you don't have, like, this kind of, you don't have Kobe to pull from, right? You don't have, like, this, you don't have a lot of figures that create this, like, feeling, like, it's your shoe. And I feel so connected to it already, just knowing, like, the story behind it and understanding, like, you know, it's something that I really want to try to build in cycling where you have that attachment to your team, right?
Yeah.
And the people that come through that team. And for me, like, you know, Kobe's been, like, this polarizing figure in my life just growing up in LA. And, like, having someone that made you feel like, just work hard, just put in the work, and no matter what happens, no matter what the climate or the atmosphere in the world is, if you put in the work, you can get where you need to go. Mm-hmm. It's that whole Mamba mentality. So, like, yeah, this is incredible, man. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm, like, shaking.